We're now going to talk to Duterte spokesman, attorney Salvador Panelo. Secretary, welcome to the program. Thanks for taking our call. Appreciate it.
Good noon, Carmina.
All right, so you've already said that this move by the Solicitor General is independent of the president's office. But here's a question. Does he welcome it?
The president welcomes any petition by any agency of the government against any transgressor. He welcomes that because that is the duty of each department or office to file any action in court relative to any transgressions of the law.
This rumor about...
But it has not, but let me be very clear. It has nothing to do with his expression of displeasure when he became a victim of fraud.
All right, we're going to talk about that later on, but first I need to ask you, what did the president tell the Solicitor General regarding the plan to file this cobaranto? I mean, you and I both know that this news has been circulating for a couple of weeks already, even more than that. What did the president say to the Solicitor General?
He hasn't said anything. That's why, as I was saying, he does not interfere with the work of his officials.
So
he
never...
interferes only when there is the complaint of corruption or abuse of power.
So never have they spoken about this?
None that I know of.
Now, Mr. Secretary, some lawmakers have already spoken up saying what the Solicitor General did was an encroachment on the co-equal powers of the three branches of government. Some saying it's an assault on the freedom of the press. How would you, as spokesperson of the president, describe this co-warranto petition?
Absolutely wrong. The Congress has the exclusive authority to grant franchises. There is no question about that. But when a franchise is granted and the franchise holder violates or transgresses the law, then the Solicitor General has the authority and the mandate to file a petition to withdraw such a grant of franchise.
Now, Rule 66 talks about usurpation, am I correct?
Yes, among others.
Right. It doesn't talk about violation. How would you describe this? Would you clarify the grounds presented by Solicitor General Kalida as usurpation or violation of said franchise agreement?
I haven't seen the petition, so I cannot make any comment. I think it should be the SOGEN that should be responding to that question.
Well, he refused to talk to the media this morning. Now, there were several bills.
But I understand he already issued a statement.
Mm-hmm.
Vis-a-vis that, so.
Yeah. All right, so let's move on with this interview. There are several bills, Attorney Panelo, already pending in Congress for the franchise renewal, as you know. The issues raised by the Solicitor General can very well be raised during the franchise hearings, and yet he moves to nullify the franchise via this co-warranto petition. Tell us, Mr. Secretary, how is this move not limiting the democratic space here in the country?
How can it limit the democratic exercise of whatever freedom you have in mind? You must remember that it is his constitutional duty to perform a task assigned to him by the Constitution and by the law, and that is to file petitions against transgressors. Now, with respect to Congress, it has the authority to grant franchise. They can call a hearing on that, and those who oppose it can come, and those who are for it can also present themselves. It is Congress that will decide whether or not ABS-CBN will get a renewal of its franchise, not the president.
But then they're sort of painted into a corner now. What do you think should happen next? Should the Supreme Court act on this petition with dispatch, or should the lower house finally step in and say, you know, we have these pending bills that we need to hear, Mr. Secretary?
Each branch of the government has its own constitutional duty to perform. The Supreme Court, when petitions are filed before it, they will hear it. Congress, with respect to granting of a franchise, they will be hearing it. So nobody's encroaching into its territory.
So to your mind, this should not prevent Congress from hearing the franchise of ABS-CBN from conducting those franchise hearings?
I don't think so. You know, it reminds me of the case of the former Chief Justice Sereno. Remember then that Congress or some of the senators or members of Congress were reacting against the petition because they say that impeachment would be the proper remedy and they cannot be deprived of that.
Correct.
And our argument then, which the Supreme Court upheld, is that this is a different petition because Chief Justice at the time, Sereno,
mm-hmm.
violated certain laws and provisions. That is precisely why there was a petition for a co-warrant against her. It's identical. It's the same.
So now you're expecting...
You don't deprive Congress of its authority.
Right. So now we're expecting a healthy debate here. Isn't it pitting these co-equal branches against each other?
I don't think so. There's checks and balances precisely that was designed by the framers of the Constitution so that they can, each one can check each other's exercise of power.
All right. Finally, Mr. Secretary, this latest development, it did not happen in a vacuum. We all know the sentiments of the president regarding ABS-CBN. The question now is, how would you explain to the public that what we saw this morning wasn't the weaponization of the Office of the Solicitor General against those perceived to be enemies of the president?
Again, as I said, the constitutional duty assigned to the Solicitor General is to file cases against transgressors of the law. With respect to president's expression of displeasure or hurt by being a victim of fraud during the campaign is or falls within the freedom of expression. And you cannot deprive him of that as a citizen of this country.
Spokesperson of Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte there, Secretary Salvador Panelo, thank you for taking our call. We appreciate you joining us this noon. Thanks again.